good morning again, everybody. That was a not so restful 6 hours, but at least I got some motel coffee to show for it, so that's something, I guess. We're loaded up, ready to start riding again. About 48 degrees out here so far this morning, according to the pocket thermometer, but it's supposed to get up to about 60 something today, 65, 68. So it should be a good day for riding. We're here in basically north central Ohio, so let's get on the road. All right, folks, we made it. We're here at the world famous Ohio 555, just south of Zanesville, Ohio, the east side of Columbus. So we're gonna head down 555. I think it goes for many miles, 40, 60 miles, something like that. Great ride. We'll see you along the way. about three quarters of the way through Ohio 555 here. Just wanted to show you this view. Man, you know, my thoughts right now, this road is a great bike ride. Very well worth the time to come up here, the time and the mileage. Look at that view back there. All along this road has beautiful scenery like this. Very hilly, roller coaster type hills. You know, those where you pop up to the top and you can't see over. If you're going a little too fast, you will catch some air off of some of them. I'm not doing that, but I know you could. It's a little bit drizzly here today, so it'll drizzle off and on. The road's a little bit damp, so I'm really taking my time so that I don't bust my hind end out here in the middle of nowhere. I don't want to bust my hind end anywhere, especially out here in the middle of nowhere. But like, look at these views up here. It is spectacular. But like I said, very well worth the ride to come out here. Wherever you're from, you won't regret it. right, so that was the Triple Nickel Ohio State Route 555. That was my first time I ever rode it, of course. As I said in the video, it had been drizzling all morning. It was wet. You know, to be honest with you, I was a little bit intimidated because the way the road starts off going from north to south, you know, one of the first things you do on that road is some roller coaster type hills. And first time on it, you know, intimidated, wet, I took it pretty easy. Didn't have any issues taking it easy. Couple times cars come up behind me and I would, you know, move over when it was safe in the driveway or something, let them go around. What are my thoughts on the road? It was a great road. It was very worth the time and whatever to go there to ride that stretch of road. Comparing it to the Tail of the Dragon, kind of, you know, a lot of people have rode the Tail of the Dragon and a lot of people have heard about it and watched videos on it and all that kind of stuff. I've rode the Tail of the Dragon. Comparing Ohio State Route 555, the Triple Nickel, to the Tail of the Dragon, I would say the Triple Nickel is more challenging than the Tail of the Dragon. The Tail of the Dragon has 318 turns and 11 miles. It's a beautiful ride. The Tail of the Dragon is a beautiful ride. It's very challenging in the sense that you have to pay attention to what you're doing. There's a whole lot of traffic. There's, you know, people on sports bikes trying to do it as quickly as they can. There's people in sports cars that are trying to do it as quickly as they can. There's guys on their spouse with them that's just trying to take it nice and easy and have a nice Sunday drive. All those things make the Dragon challenging. 555 is challenging in the sense that imagine the Dragon with roller coaster type hills. The hills that you can't see until you literally are on the top of the hill. You don't know which way the road goes on the other side. You can't tell if there's a pickup truck coming on the other side because the hill's so steep you can't even see the roof of the pickup truck. 555, you saw in this video, you kind of know what I'm talking about after you watch this video, but 555 also has a lot of 90 degree turns, 60 degree turns, you know, where the recommended speed on that curve is 15 miles an hour, 10, 15, 20 miles an hour, so pretty decent curves. 62 miles long, 555 is, where the Dragon's, you know, 11 miles, the actual Dragon is 11 miles. But anyway, in my opinion, I would rank 555 as a little bit more difficult and just as good of a ride as far as scenery and all that kind of stuff. Beautiful all the way there, beautiful all the way along 555, and then beautiful going away from there. Car and Driver 2020, they made a list of the 12 best roads in America for driving or motorcycling on. Ohio 555 was ranked number one on that list, you know, 3 years ago at the time I'm filming this. Great road, great ride. I would do it again in a heartbeat. I will do it again in the future when it's, you know, a little warmer and a little drier. But if you've never been, it's definitely a bucket list item. If you're a motorcyclist, if you're a guy that likes to ride the, you know, the scenic, challenging type roads, put that one on your list. I appreciate y'all riding along. Let me know what you thought of the video. If I need to do a different technique in filming, or, you know, let me know what your thoughts are and we'll consider it. Like the video if you liked it. Click like. Comment for me. Subscribe. I appreciate you watching. Thanks and have a great day.